In this video, I'm going to show you how to add tooltips to your charts in Google Data Studio. Hi, this is Ahmad from Siavak, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to add tooltips to your charts and graphs or reports in Google Data Studio. If you use Data Studio frequently to create reports for your company or your clients, you know that what we represent on the reporting dashboard is not necessarily clear for the viewer of the report. Right now, the only options that we have is to add paragraphs of text and notes here and there on the report canvas. That's why we decided to come up with a solution and create a custom component that solves this challenge, the tooltip. Let's take a closer look and see how it works. And make sure to stick around to the end because I'm going to show this free component with you so you can also use it on your reports. Let's begin. Okay, so first let's see some examples of how this tooltip slash popup component works on the report, and then we'll see how we can add it to our Data Studio reports and how we can adjust the settings and configurations of this component. So on this page we have a table, and the first thing that you will notice, and I hope you to notice, is that little yellow warning sign at the top. If we hover on it, a popup appears with some more information about the metric that is presented on the table. In this case, we can see that the conversion rate is based on users, not sessions, and what formula has been used to calculate the conversion rates on this table. Another thing that you might have noticed is this little help sign at the bottom. Again, if we hover the mouse pointer on it, a popup appears underneath with some more information. So basically, that's the component. This tooltip slash popup component has two parts. First is the knob or the icon, which is visible all the time. And the second part is this popup that only gets visible when we hover the mouse icon on the knob section. As you can see, this tremendously helps us to save a space on the report page and just present information when it's needed and when the viewer of the report is interested to see that information. Now I'm going to show you how you can add this component to your own Data Studio reports and how you can set it up to look like this or like this, and also a few more examples. Let's go back to edit mode and add the component. To add the component, first we need to use this menu, Community Visualizations, and then you need to click on Explore More, and finally build your own visualization. The tooltip component is not yet publicly available through Data Studio, so we need to use this section to access it. To add the component, we need to enter the manifest part in here. And for that, this is the exact address that you need to enter or type into the manifest part input, and then click submit so you can access the popup component by siavak. When you click on it, you can place it anywhere on your report like this. One thing that you need to note about this component is that you need to assign a data source to it and select a metric. We will see how the data source and metric can be useful later on in this tutorial, but for now, it's important for you to make sure to edit the data source and make sure that the community visualization access is set to on. Otherwise, the component will not work and will show an error message. Now, let's assume that we want to adjust this tooltip component to show some more information and the definition of the landing page. For the people who don't know what is a landing page and what is a normal page in a Google Data Studio report. So first of all, I moved it over here and I resized the component, and then I need to head over to Style tab to access all the settings and configurations of this tooltip component. The first checkbox that we see here is always visible. When we are going to design our popup or tooltip, it's best for us to have this check so we can see how the component looks and feels in real time as we go through the configurations. So I check this one, and I don't like this menu at the top. So what I want to do is to set the chart headers to do not show and then scroll to the top. The first thing that we can set here is the bubble content, and it's actually the information that we want to present when
the mouse pointer is hovered on the knob portion of the tooltip. So here I want to say that landing page is the first page visited in a session. That's basically the definition of the landing page. I'm happy with this question mark to be the content of the knob, but we can put anything here. We can put an emoji, or we can write something. We can write a question mark, or we can write what's a landing page. Or if that's too long, we can just put an I in here for information, or we can put just a question mark. Then we can decide where do we want the knob to be positioned, at the bottom left, bottom right, top right, or top left. In this example, I'd like to be top left because I want the pop-up to appear here. And then we can set the fill option for the pop-up part of it. So do we want to fill the space horizontally or vertically, or both horizontally and vertically, or do we want to overlay the knob portion as well? I will get to this one later. Then we can adjust the style and family for the font, just like we can do with the Google font component. You can watch the YouTube video on that after this, and then we can adjust the font size as well. Now, we have full access over the colors as well. So the text color could be maybe black, and the background color could be yellow. And I want the knob text color to be, again, maybe blue. And for the background, I want it to be white, just to blend with the background of the table. And finally, we can apply a border radius to the pop-up section just to make the corners a bit rounded. That's it. Now I can go to the style tab again and uncheck the always visible, so we can only see the question mark in here. If we go to the view mode, we have our question mark here. We can hover over it and we can see that it shows us the information the way we set it up in the style tab. So now you exactly know how this one has been set up. We have an emoji for the knob content and white for the knob background color, and some text here. For this one, let me show you. For this one, I actually used HTML in the bubble content. So I used the bold tag to make users bold, and then I used the line break tag and italic tag to style the text that I have on the pop-up, just like this. So these are bold, there are two line breaks, and then this portion is italic. Okay, that was the basic usage and settings of the tooltip / pop-up component. In the rest of this tutorial, I'd like to show you some creative ways to use this tooltip component and some advanced settings that you can apply. So stay with me if you want. Okay, let's go to view mode and see the next page. In this example, I've set the tooltip component to show different content and different knob icons based on the ranges of the metric that we have applied to it. If you remember at the beginning of the tutorial, I said we have to assign a data source and a metric to the tooltip component, and we'll get to that later. Now we can see how we can use that metric to change the behavior of the component. So right now, if I hover on this one, it says that the metric is above target. The target that I've defined is 20,000. So if the number of new users is more than 20,000, this is the icon that is going to be shown, and this is the information that is going to be shown to the user. But if we use the device category to just filter the report and narrow down the number of new users to, let's say, close to 14,000, then you can see that the icon changes to a warning sign, and if you hover on it, if the user hovers on it, it says that the metric is below target. And similarly, if we just only show the new users from tablet, which is less than 5,000, this is also a number that I have defined, a range that I have defined in the settings of the component, then it changes to a red cross. And then you can hover on it and see that it says that the metric is critically low. So depending on the metric that is presented on the report, you can show dynamically different content with different styling and with different icons. Let's take a quick look and see how we can set this up. So if I click on that, instead of setting up the content at the top in the bubble content and knob content, I just left them there to be default content and a question mark. But at the bottom, what I've done is that I enabled the ranges. We can enable up to 5 ranges. Here I have enabled 3 ranges. The first range is from 5,000 to 2,000. And our metric, as you can see, is new users. Okay. If the number is between 5,000 and 20,000, this is the content that is going to be shown. This is the icon that is going to be shown as the knob content. This is the font size, and these are the colors for the background and text color. The next range from 0 to 5,000, it says the metric is critically low. It shows a red cross, and it uses red as a font color to show it's really critically low. And the final one, the final range is from 20,000 to 1,000,000, which is a really high maximum that I've put here. It uses the green color and a check mark and says the metric is above target. So that's basically how you can set up the tooltip popup component to dynamically show different content and different icons based on the metric that is presented on the report. Next, and finally, I'd like to show you 2 creative ways of using this tooltip component. The first one is a full overlay. So here I have a trend line, a time series, and I have a reference line applied to this time series chart. I have a scorecard with comparison and a title. So all of these with the text here, I've used them to create a group of components that shows a scorecard with some trend and some reference line to show the target for that trend. And if you've noticed, this little eye at the top right is a tooltip popup component. If I hover on it, it completely covers all the group of components below and shows some information to the user. And as soon as you move out your mouse cursor, again, you can see that component and the trend line and the scorecard. Just like this. It's a really nice effect, isn't it? But it has just a little tiny problem. Let's see what it is and what we can do about it. So next page, we have a standard tooltip versus popup. So this one is exactly like that. You hover on it and it covers all the components and the graphs below to show you information. But as a side effect of covering all the components below is that I had to use this tooltip component and I had to size it exactly the way that it covers all the components below. And that means that this is also covering the ability to interact with the charts below that. So if I move it over here, so it only covers half of the chart and go back to the view mode, you can see that when we are hovering on the trend line on the time series, we can see the actual numbers. We can interact with the chart. If it was a table, we could use to sort with it. If it was an interactive chart, we could click and interact with it or cross-filter the rest of the report. But as soon as I move my mouse in the area that this tooltip has covered, I cannot interact with the chart below anymore. This is a side effect that we need to accept if we want to put a tooltip or popup above any chart or graph. But what if you don't actually care about the fancy looks of this, but you want some properly functioning tooltip without compromising the rest of the features of your report, without compromising the ability to interact with the items beneath that? I was thinking about this and I was talking and discussing this with my developer to see if we can find a workaround. And finally, we found a creative way of putting HTML in the tooltip to create a standard tooltip that doesn't cover anything below that except the actual area that is used to show the icon. Let's see how it works. If I hover on that, you can see a standard browser-based tooltip. We don't have any control over the font size or colors or the background colors or any of these fancy stuff, but we can show as much information as we can, and it doesn't actually cover anything below that. Let's quickly take a look and see how we can set it up. So let me go back to edit mode and remove this one and bring this one and place it here close to the time series, just right here. And it's on the back, so I have to use the arrange menu to order it and bring it to the front. Okay, so let's go back to view mode and hover on that. As we can see, the information not only is covering the trend line below, but actually it's going over the edges of the canvas of the document. But despite that, it is not covering any of the interactions that we can perform with the time series graph below that. So the only space that is covering is just as much as needed to show the icon. The way to set it up is to use HTML and a link tag, an A tag, with an empty href, so it is not linked to anywhere, but using the title attribute to actually place the text for the tooltip inside of it. And for the actual text shows as the link, we can put anything. We can put help, or we can put an emoji, just like I did before. So to recap, we can use the tooltip component to show information on a chart without actually making our report cluttered and busy looking, and we can save time and only show information when user actually wants to know about it. And we can dynamically show different types of information based on the ranges of the metric, up to 5 ranges of a metric that we assign to the tooltip component. And if we don't want it to cover the charts and graphs below that, we can use an HTML A tag with its title attribute to create a standard browser-based tooltip.
That's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Now it's your time to use tooltips to declutter your dashboards and improve their clarity and user experience. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. And if you're new to Measure School, make sure to subscribe so you can get notified of the future videos that we publish. This is Ahmed, and I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next video.